within the rules by slowing the ball down, and also on our kicking game, to make sure that we slow them down that area. If we're going to kick straight to them, they've got players who can run the ball back 50, 60 metres, score tries. We've got to try to make the ball dead as much as possible, put it in the touch, and then we can regroup from there, and then they've got to have scrums to run the ball out.
A cold autumn day in Halifax, but a packed Thrum Hall eagerly awaiting the kickoff as Halifax come out led by Carl Harrison. They're looking for their first win over the Aussies since 1956. Time to join our commentary team of Steve Martin, until this week coach of Featherstone Rovers, and Nick Powell.
Thank you, Rod. Halifax keep the 13, who set a new first division record for the margin of an away victory with that 72-0 success at Doncaster. Plenty of international experience, and two men from down under, the Kiwi John Schuster and Michael Hagan from Australia. The Aussies have a team not far from the one who'll step out at Wembley shortly for the first test in 6 days' time. Tim Brasher is on the right wing because Michael Hancock has a shoulder injury, which we're told puts him out of that test. Another chance then on the left wing for Wendell Saylor. Ricky Stewart is scrum half. Alan Langer and Kevin Walters will share the hooking duties. So the fifth match of the 18th Kangaroo Tour of Great Britain is underway. Mal Meninga with the opening kick. Steve Hampson collecting behind his own line for Halifax. Out to Mark Preston on the left wing. And Mark Preston, eager and willing and ready to run. Former Wigan man, Graham Hallis feeding inside. Paul Moriarty driving forward in the scrum cap. And great enthusiasm around the ground. There's John Fieldhouse, man who played 8 years ago against Australia for Great Britain. That was his last cap. Dummy half is Southernwood, Roy Southernwood. Kick is from Wayne Parker. Testing Brett Mullins, who would hope to be wearing that number one jersey for Australia in a week's time. But Halifax, much more than perhaps any of the other British sides so far, have been prepared to take the game to Australia in the opening moments. These opening moments are so important, Steve.
Yeah, very much so. It was a very good set of six by Halifax, and I'm sure the coach will be very happy with that. They went forward with the ball very well and got a good kick in down that hill and forced the scrum. Australia have got to get out of their end now.
Very much up for it. Good support for them.
They've come up with a mistake, Australia. There's been a knock-on at the scrum and Halifax feed. So that's a great start by them.
There has been a suggestion once or twice in some of the earlier club games that if you pressurise the Australian defence, well, they're human too. Halifax driving forward again with Paul Moriarty. 10 yards out. Sprinting out left. Parker feeding Fieldhouse. Fieldhouse, big, tough competitor. He'll have been looking forward to this. Parker again. Gary Devorty. Parker again. Directing the play. Moriarty takes well under pressure. And keeping the ball alive still. Carl Harrison. Again keeping the ball alive. Can Hallis hold it? He can't. And that's really what you can't afford to do when you have the Australians under pressure. You can't afford those mistakes because they will punish you for it, as Wigan and Leeds and Castleford and Cumbria have found to their considerable cost.
An interesting move there, Nick. They had big number 11 at standoff from the scrum to take the ball in.
And Halifax have the ball. Parker. Might have jinked back inside. But they are not frightened of the Australians, not one bit. Southernwood on the burst. Mark Parrott, 3-4 yards out. Options both ways. Southernwood keeps it tight. That's a nice move. Devorty coming back inside. 2 yards out. Meninga directing the Australian defence. Southernwood. Parker. Little chip might be on. Was he taken out? Referee says that's okay. John Holdsworth in there. In a good position to see. The Aussies have it 1 yard out in front of their own line. Ettingshausen. Good lively start though.
It's the start that Steve Sims wanted. He's dribbled the ball into the in-goal area and puts Australia under enormous pressure. Steve Sims would be very happy with the start of this game.
He certainly would, the Halifax coach. 4 wins in 4 games so far since Steve Sims arrived from Lee to take over from Malcolm Reilly. Thrum Hall. We're on the last tackle. And Halifax have kept the Australians well pegged back. Preston waits. Ooh, well, he never really looked confident with that one. And this is what we were saying about the Australians punishing your mistakes. Langer's away, Meninga is with him, Meninga switches it wide, and it's an easy try for Wendell Saylor. And after such an encouraging start to Halifax, one mistake and the Australians are in there, the third try of the tour for Wendell Saylor.
Well, you can see this, Nick. It was just a simple mistake. A high ball went up. The ball was recovered by the Australian team. They had numbers everywhere and just used those numbers and put the ball over the line. One mistake by Halifax and Australia scored the try. Here it is here. You can see the kick went up. The ball was dropped. There's Australian players everywhere. There's not too much cover from the Halifax team. They've got to Langer. Langer moves it on to Meninga, and Meninga just puts it over to Saylor, who puts the ball under the sticks.
So, kicking duties this afternoon to Tim Brasher, the man not really expecting to play, wasn't named in the original team, but has come in for Michael Hancock. And he'd be very disappointed if this doesn't get between the sticks. Desperately confident, but he made it all the same. And the Australians lead by 6-0. And a penalty against Australia, against Alan Langer. John Holdsworth has had a game on each of the last three Australian tours. One of the game's most respected officials, of course. Graham Hallis with a left foot kick. Different options. Schuster has the ball. It's nicely done. John Bentley coming inside from the wing. Anna got a hat trick last week. Southernwood sold a nice dummy. Had a couple of yards. Fieldhouse and Parker. Michael Hagan. That's a useful kick into the corner. Can Hallis get there? He can't quite. Good cover from Saylor. Just a moment's rough stuff. But, John Glover, touch judge with the yellow flag in very quickly to sort that out.
Yeah, they're very good tactics by Halifax. The ball has been passed too wide and the kick from Hagan goes in behind the line. And you'll notice that Ricky Stewart is playing in the line and the fullback's up close. And what you do is put the ball back into the in-goal area.
Halifax do look very organised this afternoon. And when he arrived, Steve Sims said he was going to spend many an hour in front of the video machine checking how they'd been defending and working on improving that. And talking to John Bentley a week ago after their 72-0 victory, it was the defence that he highlighted about the Halifax had improved most over the last month or so. There's Mark Perrott, this promising Welshman. I'd expect to be involved in some form when Wales play Australia at the end of the month at Ninian Park. There's Fieldhouse. Inside the Australian 25, Carl Harrison. Good powerful run by the prop. Is this the moment? Devorty switches it back inside. Southernwood, Parker. Momentum isn't really there. Hagan thought about the long pass. That's useful if it bounces right for John Bentley. It has done. And John Bentley, the man who got a hat-trick last week against Doncaster, has done it against much more powerful opposition this week. And Halifax gain reward for their early pressure. John Bentley, the policeman who used to play rugby union, makes Halifax back in the game.
Again, we can see that in the end, the kick does the job for Halifax. You'll see here, Hagan does a couple of dummies, run wide, put the ball in behind the defence. And Bentley, he scores plenty of those types of tries.
John Schuster, 10 goals last week. Tricky day, tricky angle, tricky wind. No problem. And that really will boost them. It's little moments like that that can help lift a team. And we're all square.
Well, here it is again. You can see here they work one way, the ball switched back again, and they've done that play a couple of times. It's a little bit off the cuff now. Hagen's got the ball. Dummy player comes back inside. Ball goes in behind the defence, and Bentley right on the spot.
Waiting and acting halfback is Southernwood. Gary Devorty, experienced player. There's a Hull and Leeds on the last tackle. Hampson will kick. Herrick, the first man up to challenge Saylor, and Saylor didn't manage to take it on the first bounce, but the referee deciding that the infringement came from Halifax. And just a little word for Brett Mullins from John Holdsworth.
Yes, you can see here the Halifax players were definitely offside, and you've got to stay within 10 metres from the player, and you can see here they just didn't, and they're offside.
And the Saylor. Oh, he burst through the tackle of field out, although he wasn't there. Stronger perhaps than he looks, Wendell Saylor. 15 stone. Good ground made by Bradley Clyde. Langer acting halfback. Fittler waiting. Harrigan. The chief bursting through two or three men. Going sideways rather than forwards. Langer to Stewart. Almeninga. Shaking off tackles. Still such a strong man, Malmeninga. Langer to Fittler. Fittler is trying to weave his way through. Out of your picture, Paul Moriarty waiting to come back onto the field for Halifax. As Australia try again. And the kick through was by Ettingshausen. And calm defence by Michael Hagen. And some pressure from Tim Brasher. So we'll give him the benefit of the doubt that he knew what he was doing.
Yes, Hagen's just finished it off there and put the ball dead to ensure a drop out for Australia.
Saylor waits. First real opportunity to run.
It's a very dangerous period for Halifax now. They must hang in there and not let Australia score in the next 4 or 5 minutes.
Yeah, you wouldn't bet against an Australian try in that period. Besides that feeling about it. Let's hope for the sake of an even contest that we're wrong. Glenn Lazarus. The machine is just beginning to move a little more smoothly, you feel. Stewart to Daly. Daly to Mullins, Mullins to Saylor. Can he go around the outside? Brings it back inside. And there was Mark Preston in the way. Important cover. It'll be a scrum. And will Saylor have a chance to go around the outside?
It's very unfortunate for Halifax here. They run a couple of decoy plays and Halifax cleaned it up, and then they came up with an error there which put the ball over the sideline and they lose the feed.
Australia keep the pressure on. Daly misses out Meninga. And through the middle, Ettingshausen, can he get up again? Just can't quite do it. The cover's back. If he'd have stayed on his feet, he was in. Stewart. Long pass out. There are men over here. Pass was delayed. It may still be a try in the corner. Can he turn over? Not quite. Acting halfback Brasher. Australia seemed to have a real opportunity there, Steve.
Yeah, very much so. They've been building up to a try, and again, it's very important that Halifax hang in there. You can see there again that Australia are using the inside passes a lot, and then they're going very wide.
Suriman under there, and he emerges. And the referee.
They've been let off the hook, Halifax.
Nice ball forward.
It's been a knock on by an Australian player.
Suriman is the guilty party, but he can't believe it. But John Holdsworth, to be fair, was right in line.
That's just what the doctor ordered for Halifax.
Certainly as you need your breaks. Schuster.
They're not quite out of the woods yet, though. They need a good set of six and a good kick chase on the end of it.
Southernwood, Moriarty, glad to be back in the action. They're slightly driving forward in ones and twos. Halifax not showing the organisation and the imagination that they had earlier in the game. Well, Harrison always able to make you 3 or 4 yards as a minimum. Fieldhouse. That's better, but again, a mistake at the vital time, and you really cannot afford that against Australia.
Yeah. Yes, you can't do that. Australia have been pressuring them all the way, and Halifax had the chance to play six out and get the ball down that end, and they've come up with an error.
But let's not forget, Halifax deserve considerable credit. We're level. And that on the balance of play is about right.
The problem is, Nick, they're starting to get a little bit of ball on them now and field position, and it's just building up on Halifax at this time.
Untidy play the ball, but the referee says it's okay. Between Meninga and Langer. Just a little argument out of your picture between Mel Meninga and John Fieldhouse. Keep an eye on that. Maybe Stewart burrowing his way through, making 3 or 4 yards.
Australia aren't quite fluent right at the moment, but you can just feel that they're building up. And
very much so. Here we go. And we're in for a try for Bradley Clyde. And it's exactly the way that Steve Martin's been predicting. The pressure built up and built up like a pressure cooker. And eventually for Halifax, the lid came off.
Well, it's just a simple try, as I say. I think it's the pressure that's been built up. It's just a one-on-one missed tackle. There's been two easy missed tackles there. And a third one there, and Bradley Clyde goes over as easy as that. Again, it's just Bradley Clyde running straight onto the ball, a couple of steps, and it really came from the last 5 or 6 or 8 minutes build-up.
6'1", 15 stone 3, and they used it all to surge through. So a change of kicker. It's Mount Meninga this time, and it's 2 more points.
It's very important now that from this kickoff that Halifax get a very good set of defensive six on Australia, because if they don't, Australia are capable of coming back in the next 1 or 2 sets of 6. Here it is again. You can see Bradley Clyde straight through. He's a strong runner and he's a big man with a good step, and simply just runs through and puts the ball over the line.
And by Parker. Screamy at Carl Harrison. The tackle is made. Harrison eventually lets his man go. Maybe switching the ball quickly out to Clyde. Stewart. Langer. Ettingshausen called for the long pass. Langer looking left and right. Men arriving all the time. Stewart tackled by Fieldhouse coming back. Just a moment there that you thought Halifax might be opened up. The pressure isn't off. Langer, was it forward? The referee says no. Daly skipping inside. Loose pass there, and Parker was there to intercept, and that was very important for Halifax. A little bit of sixes and sevens. And the referee taking the pressure off anyway.
Again, you can see here Australia putting Halifax under all sorts of pressure, and Halifax are off the hook again. Most of the defence was still coming back onside. Parker cleans up and then gets a penalty for holding it down in the tackle.
And Australia will be down to 12 men as Brett Mullins receives the punishment for chatting back to the referee. John Holdsworth is having none of it. And he will have 10 minutes in the sin bin. Here's Perrett. And he's burst onto the scene in the last year or so. As we move into time added on for injuries and stoppages at the end of a half. that Halifax will be very pleased with as the hooter goes. Applause, cheers all round the ground, and the crowd know and the players know that really for the first time on this tour the Australians have been made to work really hard in a first half that ends with them just in front. 2-1, Saylor and Clyde against 1 from Bentley. At half-time, it's Halifax 6, Australia 12.
A great deal more rugby league after the break.
You love the smell of fabric conditioner, but does it last on your laundry?
Mine does. Now I've changed to New Lenor Plus. My washing stays fresh for up to 5 days.
New Lenor Plus has time-release freshness. Freshness that's released slowly. Day after day after day.
This is fresh.
I've just put it out, but I washed it 5 days ago.
With New Lenor Plus, the freshness stays for up to 5 days.
If I could take you up in paradise up above, if you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream.
At your local Shire Ford dealer, there's more than just one Escort for you to choose from, so there's bound to be one that's right for you. And starting from only £8,995, the Escort is an absolute dream to drive. Visit your local Shire Ford dealer. We've a great deal to offer.
If you're looking for a mortgage through Pearl, you might think we'd make a song and dance about it.
A mortgage? A mortgage?
We got low stock, we got high stock, we got fixed and we got capped.
A mortgage.
There's a dollar total payment when the interest rate is mapped.
A mortgage.
We got LifeLink, we got PlatLink, we got long-term, we got short. When it comes to mortgages,
we got the lot.
In fact, with Pearl, there is no song and dance.
Lean on me.
Before we sell you a policy, a pension or a plan, we'll give you a person.
I can help you find out exactly how much you can afford. Explain about different mortgages. Help you shop around for a lender. Even help with the dreaded paperwork. We can start with just this one form.
Make Pearl People your best policy.
Curved surfaces create reflections. Curved glass creates distortions. Sony create the super flat, super Trinitron. The world's flattest tube, Sony's finest picture.
Oh, Billy, turn things off after you. You're wasting money again. Oh, and Billy, I need some shopping.
Detergent and softener. So I waste money, do I? Forget it.
Clean and soft. I suppose this bulb was expensive.
It cost over a quid less than your usual two. May come in handy when you get the electricity bill.
So, welcome back to Thrum Hall. The crowd encouraged clearly by that first half, and the Halifax team taking the field just 6 points behind as we start the remaining 40 minutes. Let's see what the Halifax coach thinks of it all so far. Steve Sims with Rod Studd.
Well, Steve, how pleased are you with that? Because it's the best opening 40 anyone's had against the Aussies this time around.
I think we've played super. The first 20 minutes were never out of their half. The latter part of the game, they were in our half. The first try they scored, it was off one of our mistakes. I don't think Mark's probably ever dropped the ball since I've been here. It's just one of them things. It was off our mistake. They scored. Other than that, I think we've probably been the best team for the first 40 minutes.
I don't think anyone fancied a Halifax win beforehand, but it's on now, isn't it?
Well, we're certainly looking that way. Maybe no one else did, but certainly all the players and myself thought we could win this game. Because we've got a lot of good players here, and 40 minutes to go. We've got a couple of slight injuries. Hopefully it won't affect our game, but we're out there to do our best anyway.
Thanks, Steve.
Okay.
And we're underway in the second half. What a very interesting 40 minutes it may turn out to be. Wendell Saylor. There are couple of changes. The man with the ball there, Dean Pay, number 17 for Australia, is on for them. Dean Pay, the man from Canterbury, who's had a pretty impressive tour so far, and would certainly be hopeful, I would think, of a place at least on the bench at Wembley on Saturday.
Yes, he has played extremely well, and Ian Roberts is on as well for Australia.
So as promised, Bob Fulton, the Australian coach, is giving as many as possible of his squad a chance to impress as he assesses his options, and there are plenty of them for the first test. There's Ian Roberts, number 16. You saw in the picture there, big tall man, former Wigan and briefly Sheffield Eagles player. Bradley Clyde, tackled by Harrison and by Devorty. Fittler, and squeezed through a gap between Harrison and Southernwood. It closed though. Dean Pay offloading the two substitutes together, and Roberts couldn't hold the ball. Let's have a check for you on the first half statistics. The ball dropped six times each by Halifax and Australia, most crucially of course from Halifax by Mark Preston, that brought the Australian opening try. The scrum's taken seven to Halifax against three from Australia, and Halifax generally looking the more impressive in the scrum. Line breaks, crucial statistic there, and just the one for Halifax, four by Australia. And penalties conceded, five for Australia. Steve Sim, I think, will be delighted with the discipline there, just two. John Fieldhouse running straight into Roberts, managing to offload the ball. Here's Harrison to Hagen. Hagen has men outside him. There's an overlap here, possibly. Callas can Brentley get down the wing, not quite, plays the ball back inside as he ran into touch himself, and the ball dropped, and Australia can attack again themselves, no doubt with the words of Bob Fulton and the coaching staff ringing in their ears.
I'm sure Steve Sims won't be happy with that play. Bentley went to the outside and conceded the ball.
It's good work from Australia, quick handling by Meninga. Meninga acting halfback. Langa waits in the line. Dean Pay, first from Brasher from fullback, didn't get the ball, and Australia lose the ball, and John Holdsworth says carry on, that's okay. And here's John Fieldhouse, and there were men to his left that he could have just flung a pass out. Steve Hampson playing the ball back to Southernwood. Paul Moriarty. Mark Perrott keeping on his feet. Harrison flinging the ball out wide. Preston with a chance to run past Saylor. Saylor hangs on to the arm and literally flings his man over the line. So Australia back to 13 men. And we'll see whether Mullins reverts to fullback. Bradley Clyde is the man who's left the field for Australia. Took a little bit of a knock. There's Bradley Clyde, just being helped from the field. He certainly played his part today with the second Australian try. It may just be that he's being taken off as a precaution, because he will certainly feature in the Australian team if fit at Wembley. Now the crowd roar. Now they sense a Halifax opportunity. Carl Harrison, how many times have we seen him drive the ball forward this afternoon? A beacon of strength and hope for Halifax. Moriarty too. Clegg has a big game. Halifax appeal to the referee that men were lying on the ball in the tackle. We go on with Hagen. Hagen slips the ball back to Parker. Parker wasn't ready for it. The ball though went backwards. Play on, says the referee. Roy Southernwood has the ball. First period of sustained Halifax pressure. Nowhere to go for Perrott, but he still made a yard or two. Tackled by three men. Parker inside to Bentley. Parker Tries the little kick through. Was he blocked? The referee says he was.
And again, because you can see Ricky Stewart there in the screen there. They're playing the seven in the line, and they're very vulnerable, that kicking behind the line. They've done it again. They've had success with it before in the first half, and they've got success again.
Paul Moriarty limps away. He'll take no further part in the action, but deserves the applause that you saw him getting there.
Nick, Halifax have two players that are putting the ball in behind the line and doing it very well. Hagen and Parker at seven. They're both of them doing it exceptionally well. They've got good chases on the outside, and they're putting Australia under all sorts of pressure. They did it in the first half, and they're doing it again now.
And they've got an expert goal kicker in John Schuster, but unfortunately, for the second time this afternoon, his aim just not quite accurate. And that would have been a very useful psychological boost for Halifax. Paul Moriarty there getting treatment for the knock that he took. Stewart and Langer combining again. Dean Pay. Stewart. But there were no good options there for Ricky Stewart, so he held on. There's been a lot of reorganisation of the Australian team, even within the afternoon. Now Ettingshausen, they've still got, though, everywhere you look, men who pose a threat. Here's Wendell Saylor, the man who got those two devastating tries against Cumbria in the opening game of the tour. Ettingshausen on his shoulder, and if he could have slipped the ball out to Langer, the Australians had options. Now we're on the last tackle. Ricky Stewart, Langer again, five outside him. Bradley Clyde, Laurie Daly rather, can he go sneak over the line?
Very good defence. Very good defence by Halifax on that occasion.
Halifax able to bring the ball out just a few yards. But Laurie Daly was desperately close. Sneaked up for the line. John Bentley now, he can run, he can motor. Couldn't have a better man than Andrew Ettingshausen, though. Matching him stride for stride is John Schuster.
Nick, I think the biggest thing that will be worrying the Australian camp is they're not going forward with the ball well enough. They're playing sideways a fair bit, and they just can't get through this defence, and they're just not going forward with the ball.
Great credit to Steve Sims and his organisation. We talked to him at the start of the day, of course, about the defensive plan, and so far it's paying dividends. Steve Hampson. Under a year and a half since moving from Wigan, and Carl Harrison for the first time this afternoon. You can really point your finger at Carl Harrison and say that wasn't 100%. Just dropping the ball. Unfortunate error. Nothing wrong with the pass.
Yes, just a simple drop ball.
Langer to Daly, Daly to Mullins. Mullins somehow able to wriggle out of tackles when you think he's been caught. Brasher, now Brasher can run. There's a gap there. Brasher might go all the way. Good tackling back, though, from Gary Devorty. That's an example of reading the game. But the pressure's still on. And he's over the line. The substitute, Greg Florimo, is in. Greg Florimo, first try of the tour. And a man who didn't really expect to even be on the plane could now find himself at Wembley.
Well, it's a very, very simple try. Ball goes to Greg Florimo. He does a dummy, decides he's going to run, beats two players and just gets the ball over the line. Here it is once again. You can see he throws the dummy there, straightens up, goes straight between two players. Fieldhouse slips over and takes a player over the try line.
But it was really the run by Brasher that opened up the chance in the first place. As we see the kick comfortably put over by Mal Meninga. And Australia stretched their lead to 18 points to 6. And now Halifax really must show enormous grit and determination.
It's just basically a build-up of pressure. I think it came from a mistake from Carl Harrison. And again, it's just a build-up. A couple of good runs prior to that, and Florimo just runs on his own, puts the ball over the line.
Gorimo.
The North Sydney club. Here's Paul Sirenen. Charging.
One. Tackle was high. And Fieldhouse having a discussion about it with the referee.
You certainly don't need one of these, I can tell you that. You're better off up here in the grandstand, I think. It's a high shot, it's a very high shot, and, you know, it warranted a penalty. You just can't tackle people above the shoulders.
Very clumsy indeed from John Fieldhouse. And it was there for all to see.
It's not the sort of thing you need right now. Australia got six tackles near the halfway line.
Able to put further pressure on Halifax. And this is where you perhaps expect Australia to pull away and stretch their lead. But so far, today, Halifax have shown the character to make it much harder for them than they found it so far. Sirenen again. Seemingly undaunted by the head tackle he's just received. Langer, Daly. Daly to Meninga. Meninga taken by the Halifax substitute Lee Harland. Langer, Ettingshausen. Ettingshausen switching the ball back inside to Brasher, and again he makes that angle run that brought the last try, and it's brought another try. I think the ball just too high. Can Ettingshausen hang on? Yes, he can. Andrew Ettingshausen took a little bit of a juggle. But for the second time in 2 or 3 minutes, the angle break by Tim Brasher leads to a try, and this time it's the fifth of the tour for Andrew Ettingshausen.
Yeah, it's good football by Australia. You can see the ball's move wide here. It goes out to Ettingshausen. He runs wide with the ball, turns it back inside to Brasher. Brasher beats one tackle there, and there's good support play by Alan Langer. You'll see him just there, and he offloads the ball again. I think it's to Ettingshausen who puts the ball over the line. Again, nice wide play, good wide pass. Langer, another wide pass. Opens the play up. Ettingshausen commits two players, as you can see there. Brasher beats a player. Good support. And again, good support and good handling. And a try.
That's good stuff from the Aussies. Some of the crowd would have enjoyed that. Great credit to Ettingshausen for hanging on. Meninga's kick. The toe-poking style, poking the ball just to the left-hand side of the near post. So it's 22 points to 6. And Australia extend the lead to 16 points. 5 tries in the last game of the season for Andrew Ettingshausen, which was the first time that had been done for 6 decades. Russia is waiting. That's a good wraparound tackle. Fittler couldn't get the ball out. Well, it must have taken all of 10 seconds to ground Ian Roberts then. Langer running along the line. Made the gap for himself superbly. The support arriving all round him. Langer, he might go all the way. I've seen him do that before. Daly slips the ball. Did he go forward? Yes, it did. And that, in the end, was disappointing after a magnificent break from Alan Langer. That's what he's so good at. Sold the dummy, and he was away. Watch this.
You can see here, this was what Alan Langer's best at. He's had a couple of dummies. People hang off him. He runs across the field and straight into the hole. Should have been a try here, but a little bit sloppy at the other end of the field. This is the first time Halifax have been down in Australia's end for a fair time, so let's see what they can do with the football.
Crowd reacting as Fieldhouse slips the ball out to Parker. Parker has Harrison with him. Good tackling, though. The Australians up to the job so far. Parker feeding Greenwood, the substitute. And the last tackle. If we bring in the Australians back, they come back reluctantly onside. Schuster chipping the ball through on the last tackle. Mullins waits, the positioning was perfect, and he's away past two men. Just looking to slip it back to Ettingshausen. Just found that he wasn't quite there on the shoulder. Ettingshausen acting halfback now.
Halifax were very disorganised in that set of six, and they didn't do anything with the ball. And it was the first time they've been down in their end.
Great burst from Laurie Daly. Now Daly's got support. Meninga going right. Brasher coming left. Wendell on the far side. Meninga could go all the way himself. Slips it back inside to Saylor. And Wendell Saylor will jink and turn and twist. And Wendell Saylor is over the line for his try, the second of the afternoon. His fourth of the tour. And the 20-year-old who'd so dearly loved to be in that team at Wembley has staked his claim again.
Well, this is a long-range try. You can see Laurie Daly makes the break there. Carl Harrison can't get across to get hold of him. Laurie Daly slows back. He looks like he's in a canter. He's waiting for his support players to come. He decides to go to the outside to Meninga. Meninga brings Wendell Saylor inside, and he beats one or two and plants the ball over the try line.
Ready for his 42nd test at Wembley next week. Mal Meninga. Extraordinary kick. This is a very far away in the end. Roy Southernwood taking the applause of the crowd and indeed applauding them for their support. Carl Harrison has won the Halifax Man of the Match award, and Laurie Daly has picked up the same honour in the Australian ranks. That's a great break. Here's Hampson. He's got support outside him. The pass is well timed, and the substitute is going to have a moment of glory. It's Richard Smith, and he'll remember it forevermore. The Kuala international, 21 tries for the A team last year. On his debut, what a moment! What a moment for the youngster. Doesn't matter in the course of the game. But what a lovely day for him.
Well, it's a little chip here. It's by Parker. It was a set play. You had Hampson chasing it. He picks it up. They don't use the sweeper Australia. Hampson gets to the fullback, or Wendell Saylor it is, the wide pass, and it's a clear run for the substitute to score the try in the corner.
Couldn't believe his luck, Richard Smith. The wind swirling, looks up. It'll be impressive if it goes over, and it does. Well done, John Schuster. 26-12, Australia lead.
Here it is, it was set up. Hampson knew it was on. He was on the chase. It was a very good chip, not too deep. You can see the support player there. Wendell Saylor had to go in and commit himself. Hampson put the ball out to the substitute, and he's beaten Brasher to the line.
And there goes the hooter, and the crowd roar their appreciation of what's been a really sterling effort by Halifax. They haven't won, and frankly for the last 20-25 minutes it's been clear that they weren't going to win. But they know, the people who've come from all around the Calderdale area to see this game, and from further afield too, that Mal Meninga's team have been given a much sterner test than they've faced elsewhere in Yorkshire so far on this tour. Well, let's hear from one of the successful Australians with Rod. It's Laurie Daly.
Well, Laurie, is that the hardest game you've had on tour so far?
Yeah, it certainly was. Halifax played terrific amount of football, and they certainly stuck it to us today.
How does that make you feel going into next week's test match? Was it a good run out for you, a good hard workout?
Yeah, it certainly was. I've been here in 90 and 94, and this is the hardest club side we've had to play so far. And going into the test match, I think you need a hard hit out, and we certainly got that today. And hopefully we'll brush out a few cobwebs and get it right for next Saturday.
Thanks, Rory. Well played.
Thanks, mate.
Well, that's an interesting view indeed. The hardest club game on this tour or the last tour. the final score. Credit to Halifax, but the victory to Australia. It's Halifax 12, Australia 26.
A great deal more rugby league after the break. A pint of Mansfield takes a moment or two to settle. But, like they say, all good things come to he who waits. Mansfield Bitter, the perfect head on the perfect body.
Do you like a choice of freshness from your fabric softener?
Yes, but now I get it from Bold. If I want a blue softener, I choose Bold Spring Fresh. And if I want a yellow one, I choose Bold Summer Meadow Fresh. He likes Blue Bold. She likes the yellow one. And the blue one.
Bold Spring Fresh and Summer Meadow Fresh. Now the choice is yours.
Ah, Mostyn, thank goodness we can go to the party together.
Yes, I've just got to make a call.
Well, devil, Mostyn, anyone I know?
Probably not. I'm phoning my Alliance account.
But it's 7 o'clock on a Saturday evening.
Well, they do 24-hour phone banking, 365 days a year.
Good evening, how can I help?
Hello, I'd like to pay my gas bill, please.
Could I have the second and fifth letters of your password, please, sir?
Yes, it's B-O.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks very much.
Ah, who can play that game, Mostyn? Hello, yes, I'd like the balance of my account, please. Really? Two big ones, eh?
Hello?
Marvellous. Mostyn? Mostyn?
Mostyn! Mostyn! Stop the train!
The Alliance account. Call free now on 0500 959595.
I couldn't put it down.
Patrick Colhern.
A dramatic expose of the world of business.
The Literary Times.
Authoritative and detailed. Every page enlightens the reader.
Catherine Dodds.
One of the greatest non-fictional works in the English language.
Jane.